All right, so this is something that I've been waiting for quite some time, guys. The Extreme Z Awakening details for the LR Android 17 and 18 have officially been revealed, and I haven't seen them yet, but I do have some pretty high hopes. So without further ado, let's jump right into it, starting with the pre-Extreme Z Awakening details, which honestly are laughably bad, but it's understandable considering they're super old, right? So the leader skill is all types, key plus 4. That's it. No attack, no defense, no HP, but at least they're technically a rainbow leader, I guess. Their 12 key super attack causes colossal damage, and 18 key super attack causes mega colossal damage and lowers attack and defense, and passive is attack plus 15,000 when performing a super attack, and of course no defense. So like I said, guys, they were pretty awful without the Extreme Z Awakening. They, I would say, were unusable. I mean, you could use them for like a token event, but if you're talking about like anything harder than that, Super Battle Road, Legendary Goku event, so on and so forth, they were definitely unusable. So moving on to the Extreme Z Awakening details now. The leader skill is going to become all types key plus 4, HP, attack, and defense plus 80%. Okay, so that is definitely an improvement. It's not amazing, but it's usable now. So 80% key plus 4, maybe for something like Battlefield, it could be a decent sub lead, right? And then 12 key super attack raises attack and defense for one turn, causes colossal damage, and lowers attack and defense, not bad. 18 key super attack greatly raises attack and defense for one turn. I like that. Causes mega colossal damage and lowers attack and defense. Okay. And then passive. Attack and defense plus 78% when performing a super attack. Oh, okay. So they don't get any defense before the super. Not a huge fan of that, but okay. Extreme class. Key plus 4, defense plus 50%, that's good, plus an additional key plus 3, attack plus 78%, and launches an additional attack, which has a medium chance of becoming a super attack when attacking super class enemies, alright, and super class enemies defense, minus 78%, damn, that's crazy, that's very similar to the LR Great Saiyaman 1 and 2, right, where they debuff extreme class enemies versus super class here. But from what I can see, after they super, they should be really, really good. Like they're getting, 30% attack and defense on the 12 key super, 50% attack and defense on the 18 key super, and then you're getting 78% attack and defense for the super attack, in addition to the 50% support for extreme class, which they're also getting. And yeah, they should have some pretty good defense after the super. I wouldn't say they're gonna be like an amazing tank, but they should hold their own for most things after the super. Once again, they're not gonna be a slot one unit. They do get this 50% buff, you know, without supering, but it's really not gonna give them that much defense, so do not put them in the first slot. But yeah, with these attack boosts here, they should be getting probably like at least 4 to 5 mil attack stat, I would say. But of course, I don't know for sure. I haven't seen them in action. I haven't really had a chance to test them, so I'm not, you know, too sure about what the calculations would look like. But just on paper, I think they're going to hit pretty hard. I just wish they got some kind of attack and defense boost, you know, without supering. Like maybe if it was just 78% attack and defense straight up without having to super first, they would be better. But I'm kind of just nitpicking here because I think it is a really good Extreme Z Awakening. It's not the best EZA I've seen on paper right now. I don't know if they're better than LR First Form Frieza. They might be comparable. I mean, they do have this additional super, but only against super class enemies. So you know, if you're facing an extreme class enemy, then they're missing a good chunk of this passive. But then again, you're probably never going to be running them if you know you're going to be facing a lot of extreme class enemies, right? So it shouldn't matter too much. But it is one knock against them, the fact that they're really not going to be too effective against extreme class. But yeah, that's the Extreme Sea Awakening, guys. My hopes were high, and I think they pretty much met them. They definitely did not exceed them, but I think it is going to be a very, very good Extreme Sea Awakening in practice. You know, once we get a chance to Extreme Sea Awaken them and actually use them in the game, they should be putting out some pretty big damage numbers, especially with the additional supers. And defensively, after they super, they will be pretty tanky. Maybe not extremely tanky, but tanky enough for most events, like I said. So yeah, that is the LR Android 17 and 18 Extreme Sea Awakening, guys. Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think about it. Does it impress you? Does it disappoint you? Or do you think it's just good enough, you know? So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. As always, if you liked today's video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, you'll like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. While you're at it, hit that notification bell too so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, have an awesome, awesome day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.